In many environmental problems, it's necessary to get to high conversion to eliminate pollutant. Pollutant may be in low concentration, but we still need to react 90 or 99% of it. And so I just want to use kinetics here to look at the reaction time, because you'll see that it can take longer to go from 90 to 99% conversion than it would take to go from 0 to 90% conversion. And actually can take dramatically longer in some cases. And so what we're going to do is look at a simple batch reactor to do the comparison. We're going to first look at a first order reaction. The reaction, just A goes to B, where the rate constant is 0.0115. And this rate constant was just chosen to make the numbers come out even. If we do a mass balance on a batch reactor for component A, it's the change in number of moles with time equals minus sign, because A is reacting away, the rate constant times the concentration times the volume. So I've written in A, concentration times the reactor volume, which we then can write. And this is easy to integrate, where we rearrange and then integrate from 0 to time t, from our initial number of moles to our number of moles at time t. So the integration and the substitution of the limits in the integral gives us the number of moles of A at any given time divided by the initial number of moles is equal to e to minus kt. And then we're going to calculate conversion. So x is conversion, fractional conversion, and compare the different values. So I'm going to multiply conversion by 100 just to use percents. If I plug the numbers in for this rate constant, we find it takes 200 seconds batch reactor to get the 90% conversion. If instead we want to start converting 99% initially, it takes 400 seconds. And if you want to convert 99.9, it takes 600 seconds. So notice 200 seconds to convert the first 90%, another 200 seconds to convert the next 9%, and another 200 seconds to convert the next 0.9%. So it takes longer and longer to convert that last percent, the last partial percent. So it can be very difficult to get to very high conversions, but the situation is actually much worse. It takes much longer if we look at a second order reaction, because as we lower the concentration for a second order reaction, the rate's dropping a lot more. And so what I want to do is do the same calculation now for a second order reaction. So I have written down a rate constant times initial concentration. I picked a value so that we'll get the same time for a 90% conversion to make the comparison a little clearer. Now we write the rate expression. In order to simplify this, we're going to assume liquid phase, or what that really is assuming, it's constant volume. So that means I can write the mass balance, so volume cancels, and then I can solve this equation for concentration by, again, separating variables, integrating from 0 to time t, integrating from our initial concentration in the batch reactor to concentration at a later time. Keep in mind, we're still looking at a batch reactor. It's isothermal, and we just want to compare reaction time. So I've written down the calculations where we've integrated 1 over CA squared to give us minus 1 over CA, substituted the limits, where here the limits were 0 to T, and just rearranged, and then wrote the conversion. So it's important to note that conversion is only defined in terms of concentrations like this when it's constant volume. So I can do this because it's constant volume. And so I end up with an expression for X as CA0KT over 1 plus CA0KT. And then what I want to do is just do the calculation of conversion. So for 90%, as I mentioned, I picked the rate constant, so it's 200 seconds. So it's the same as for first order. For 99%, now here's where the difference is rather dramatic. Takes 10 times as long, and for 99.9%, it takes 10 times as long again. So 10 times longer. If I convert 90%, to convert that next 9% takes 10 times as long. To convert the next 9.9% takes 100 times as long. So it's a dramatic difference. For second order reaction, it can be very difficult to get to very high conversion increases dramatically to get the last percent converted to reach higher conversions. We're already at high conversion. We want to go to the next fraction of percent. Takes much longer. This is something you need to keep in mind then in systems that compared to first order, where indeed it takes longer, we're looking at really dramatic differences when we look at a second order process. And this, as I mentioned, can be important when we look at environmental problems.